For two arbitrary vectors A and B, expressed as Cartesian vectors, their dot product is a scalar and is defined algebraically as the sum of the products of their respective I, j, and k components. Geometrically, even if the two vectors are not on the same plane, they can be parallel transported to be concurrent, and they form an angle of theta. Their dot product equals to the magnitude of projection of vector A on B, A prime, multiplied by magnitude of vector B, or the magnitude of the projection of vector B on A, B prime, multiplied by the magnitude of A. Either way, the dot product equals to magnitude A times magnitude B times cosine theta. Because of the algebraic and geometric definitions of dot product can now be used to find the angle theta between the two vectors A and B following this formula. Or we can use dot product to find the projection vector of any vector along a specified axis. Note, UA is the unit vector along the AA axis. Let's look at this example. Two forces are drawn in the XYZ coordinate system, and they are also expressed in their respective Cartesian vector forms, given in the unit of kip, kilopound. We need to determine the angle between them as well as the magnitude of the projection force F1 along the line of action of F2. For this problem, we are going to use the dot product, but first let's calculate their magnitudes. Now, for the dot product, we're going to use the algebraic equation by finding the sum of the products of their respective coordinates to be -32.6. Notice that it does have a unit of kip squared. Since now we know the dot product as well as the magnitudes, for angle theta, it can be calculated as inverse cosine or arc cosine of the dot product of these two force vectors divided by their respective magnitudes to be 118 degrees. And then for the projection force of F1 along the line of action of F2, it simply equals to the magnitude F1 multiplied by cosine theta. And the absolute value is 3.4 kip. And this answers the question, but let's also look at an alternative way to solve this problem. With the magnitudes F1 and F2, alternatively, we can calculate the unit vectors of these two force vectors. And since the angle made by these two unit vectors is the same as the angle made by the original two force vectors, therefore, angle theta can be easily determined as inverse cosine of the dot product of these two unit vectors, and you will get the same answer. With the unit vector of F2 determined, the projection force of F1 along the line of action of F2 simply equals to the dot product of F1 and the unit vector UF2. You will get the same answer. However, this method is convenient when you do not need to determine the angle theta.